Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of creating a poster for Star Wars The Force Awakens, Episode 7, picking up from where we left off. Open the Rebel insignia that you created in part one and drag it onto the tab of your poster. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down onto your poster. Then release. Pressing and holding Shift kept the insignia centered. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in to approximately this size. To reposition it so the top of the insignia is centered over the brightest part of the lens flare, press the up or down arrow on your keyboard, then press Enter or Return. Double-click on the insignia thumbnail to open its layer styles. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Inner Bevel, the technique is Chisel Hard, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 5 pixels, and the soften is 0. Uncheck Global Light. Make the angle minus 10 degrees and the altitude between 45 and 50 degrees. The highlight mode is screen and its opacity is 70%. The shadow mode is multiply and its opacity is 50%. Click Contour. Open the flyout list and click Rounded Steps. Click Outer Glow. The blend mode is Color Burn, the opacity is 10%, the noise is 0, and the color is black. The technique is Softer, the spread is 0%, and the size is 250 pixels. Then click OK. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. To restrict the adjustment layer to affect only the insignia and not all the layers below it, click the Clipping Mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Now the adjustment layer is clipped to the insignia. Check Colorize and make the hue 220 and the saturation 15. Next, we'll increase its contrast. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Levels. Clip it to the insignia and slide the input midtones to approximately 0.73. Next, we'll add a highlight on top, which will give the insignia a slight glow at the brightest part of the lens flare. First, let's group the insignia and its adjustment layers into a folder. To do this, shift-click on the insignia to make it and the middle adjustment layer active as well, and press Ctrl or Command-G. I'll name the folder Resistance Insignia, but you can name it whatever you like. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Let's name it Highlight Flare. Open your Brush tool. Make it size 65 pixels and press Enter or Return. The blend mode is normal and its opacity is 80%. We want white to be our foreground color. If it isn't and your background color is presently white, click this icon to reverse the colors or press X on your keyboard. Click once on the center of the lens flare. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I'm using Trajan Pro Regular. If you don't already have this font and would like to use it, I provided its download link in my video's description. I'll make it size 20 points, smooth, and center alignment. Click on the vertical center of your document and type out your text. Open your Move tool and click the FX icon. Click Bevel Emboss. The style is inner bevel and the technique is chisel hard. The depth is 183%, the direction is up, the size is 2 pixels, and the soften is 1 pixel. Uncheck global light. The angle is minus 90 degrees, and the altitude is 10 degrees. The highlight mode is screen, and its opacity is 70%. The shadow mode is multiply, and its opacity is also 70%. Then click OK. Make a copy of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. On your original text layer, hide the effects and make the layer active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. When this message opens, click Convert to Smart Object, which makes the text editable. Make the amount 100, the blur method zoom, and the quality best. Then click OK. To save space in the Layers panel, let's group the text layers into a folder using the same steps that we used before. Shift-click on the top layer to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command G. Name it whatever you like. Press T to open your type tool, click below the insignia on the vertical center of your document, and type out your text. To resize it, click your Move tool and open your Transform tool. As you did earlier, go to a corner and drag it out to a size you like. Then press Enter or Return. To slide it up or down, press and hold the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Click the FX icon and click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is chisel hard, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 106 pixels, and the soften is 0. Uncheck global light. The angle is 90 degrees, and the altitude is 37 degrees. The highlight mode is screen, and its opacity is 70%. The shadow mode is multiply, and its opacity is 70% as well. Click Contour, and this time choose Ring. Then click OK. I think I'd like to slide the top text, the insignia, and the lens flare up a bit. So to do this, I'll make all those layers active and press and hold the up arrow key on my keyboard. We'll finish our poster by brightening and intensifying the colors of our space background on both sides of the insignia. First, make your top layer active and make a composite snapshot of your entire poster by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Open your brush tool, make it size 600 pixels, the blend mode color dodge, and the opacity 100%. Place the right edge of your brush close to the left edge of the insignia and click 2 or 3 times. Repeat this on the left side of your poster as well. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.